every one of us in this service and give God thanks for the privilege to be in His presence the first Sunday of December in the week of Shiloh 2015, where God has ordained to change your level and my level supernaturally. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. Amen. The Lord sent a word into Jacob, and He turned him into a nation. Lord, I'm here. Send me my own word today. When the word of Joseph came, his levels changed supernaturally. Lord, send me my word that will change my level supernaturally this morning. Go ahead and pray. Whatever you don't demand, you don't deserve. Oh Lord God, send me my own word today that will again change my level. Reblo riza rota prektenebo rualisa zazeru shaga. Send me my own word today that will once again change my level. Blessed be your name, Jesus. And Jesus precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And so shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Give the Lord a big hand of praise. And please, you may be seated. Would you help me first and foremost congratulate your neighbors on your right and on your left? Congratulations for saying the week of Shiloh 2015. Congratulations for saying the week of Shiloh 2015 in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Amen. Let me again take this time to welcome all of our delegates who have arrived to Shiloh 2015. It will interest us that we have 24 nations already on ground. Amen. Others on their way coming. It's going to be a time with God we will live to remember. So for delegates from these 24 nations, I say welcome for your own lifetime encounter. It will interest you to know that we have delegates already from Namibia, from Seychelles, from Rwanda, from Cote d'Ivoire, a huge multitude from Ghana, from Congo DRC, from Dubai, from Uganda, from France, from Zimbabwe, from Saudi Arabia, from India, from Tanzania, from Gabon, from Botswana, a large contingent from Botswana, from Zambia, from Belgium, from Cameroon, from South Africa, from UK, from Kenya, from Liberia, from Sierra Leone, and from the United States of America. Amen. We look forward to what heavens will open up to us at Shiloh 2015. But preparation is a covenant requirement for His manifestations. The Almighty, in His majesty, will require preparation for Him to visit anyone. Shiloh 2015 is a divine visitation Shiloh. And everyone that wants to be a partaker of such visitation must wholly subscribe to the need for adequate preparation. In Exodus chapter 19 and verse 10, God said to Moses, "Go unto the people and sanctify them today and tomorrow. Let them wash their clothes." Verse 11. "And be ready against the third day. For the third day, the Lord will come down in the sight of all the people upon Mount Sinai." And he said, "I am the Lord. I change not." So we have a responsibility. If we must become partakers of this awesome divine visitation, to subscribe wholly to the need for quality spiritual preparation. It's not about the clothes to wear. It's not about the place to sit. It's not about the place to sleep. It's about a heart that is panting for an encounter with God. A heart that is panting for an encounter with God. The psalmist said, "When thou seest, seek my face. My heart says, thy face, O God, will I seek." It's about a heart that is panting for God for a turnaround encounter. And our preparation is in sanctification. Preparing ourselves fit for an encounter with the Holy God. He said, "And let them wash their clothes." That is not just spiritual preparation, practical preparation. Things to stay away from, so you don't miss God. For when you are at home, when we are at home with the body, we are away from the Lord. So we must get to a point where we separate ourselves. The word sanctification is a separation unto God. What it means? For when we are at home with the body, we are away from the Lord. That's why many of us need to get out of where we are for once. Lift your comfort zones in your quest to find God. In your quest to find God. My prayer again is that no one winner will miss this glorious divine visitation for anything. An old English adage says, "Opportunity once lost can never be regained." You never have another Shiloh that will fall between 8 and 12. 2015 is once. 2015 will only occur once. Anyone that misses package now may miss it for life. Because there is not going to be another 2015 Shiloh. It may carry the same subject, but won't deliver the same virtues. So, everything you can do to maximize this awesome visitation, it is wisdom to do it. Remember also that glory is in levels. 1 Corinthians 15:41. There is one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, another glory of the stars, and one star exceeds another in glory, different from another in glory. So, Jesus is the Son of Righteousness. there is the glory of the Son. We have all the redemptive potentials to get at that, because the words I do you shall do, and greater words than this shall ye do. It's the glory of the moon, stronger than the glory of the stars. Then there's another glory of the stars, and what star different from another in glory. So glory is in levels. May your level change supernaturally at Shiloh 2015. From 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 12, the Bible recognizes three levels or six levels of glory. You go down to 15 and it talks about, let everyone be careful how he builds on it. Verse 13, I've laid the foundation, others are building on it. And let everyone be careful how he builds on it. For the day is coming that we'll try it out. Talks about gold, talks about silver, talks about iron, talks about wood, talks about hay, talks about stubble. He said, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, and stubble. I mean, that's classification of different levels that we belong to as believers. In 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 19, which is our text for the month, he said, verse 19, for the foundation of the Lord standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord raised them as he is, and let everyone that name the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in the great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and earth, four classes, some to honor and some to dishonor. But if any man purges himself of all these, he shall be a vessel unto honor. So you have gold, you have silver, and then you have wood, and you have earth. So, four classes. Everyone belongs somewhere. And our position is defined by our sanctification. If any man possesses of all this, shall be a vessel to honor. I pray that every participant at Shiloh will be translated into vessels of honor. And that prayer will require your taking responsibility for your personal purification and sanctification to qualify to encounter God at Shiloh and experience a supernatural change of position in your life. That preparation has no substitute. Shiloh 2015 must be a memorable Shiloh in your life. As everything begins to turn around in your favor at a frequency that no human effort can deliver. That shall be your experience in Jesus' name. Our teaching series for the month after we are done with Shiloh is Sanctification, Covenant Gateway to Glorification. Like I've mentioned, no one's life will ever be more glorified than his commitment to be sanctified. That's where our level of glorification is determined. It's determined from our commitment to please God at all times. To please God at all times. It's also important for us to know that every believer by redemption has all the spiritual potentials to be as holy as our God. and to be as perfect as our Heavenly Father is perfect. 1 Peter 1 and verse 16. Be ye holy, for I am holy. He can't tell us to be what he has not empowered us to be. Matthew 5:48. Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect. Why sanctification does not connote a state of sinlessness, but it does imply man's quest to please God at all cost as a lifestyle. You miss it? What? No. I should be smarter. Oh God, help me. Enough is enough. And God sees that sorrowful heart and releases the virtue for victory, and you walk into a new realm. What it is about? An insatiable hunger and thirst for righteousness. For blessed are they that hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Sanctification is all about an insatiable hunger and thirst for righteousness. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 6. Paul said, neither am I perfect, but one thing I do, forgetting the things that are behind, I'm reaching out the things that are in front. I press towards the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. So we keep moving, we keep taking steps, we keep moving forward. We are not satisfied with where we are. We want to see God take a hold of our life. For everyone that is genuinely thirsting after righteousness, you will meet God at Shiloh. Amen. This is so important. The reason why many are serving God without proofs, among other things, because they are not serving God acceptably. I mean, and I can tell you this, we are in a brand new season. We are what differentiates one believer from another will be service. 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 All the giants in Bible history were servants of God. All of them. So if this is a platform, the rest of giants, then it's time for the servants of God to rise. You don't have to be ordained a pastor, a deacon, no. This boy has been a servant of God for a long time. Long time. Serving the interest of another is what makes a servant. Serving the interest of another is what makes a servant. It's not a title. I have consciously been serving the interest of Jesus since 1976. Consciously. Consciously. Understandably. Yes, I've been preaching since 1970. But I became a born slave of Jesus since 76. Don't think that because you're a pastor, you're a servant of God. No, no, no. It's how much are you serving the interest of your supposed master? How much are you serving that interest? Don't say because you're ordained an elder, then you're a servant. No. It is serving the interest of your chosen master that makes you a servant. Serving the interest of your chosen master that makes you a servant. But Hebrews chapter 12 verse 28 says, let us, wherefore we receiving a kingdom that cannot be removed, let us have grace that we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear. That's what makes our service rewardable. That's what makes it profitable. Not just running up and down. Not just running up and down. Run up and down and stealing on the other side, that doesn't make a servant. That's a robber. No. Creating tension here and there, gossiping here and there, that doesn't make a servant. That's a carnal man. So for your services not to be wasted, you have to be godly. You have to be godly. You have to be godly. Somebody is giving, another man is stealing. How would they have the same reward? So sanctification underscores everything that determines your worth and my worth in the kingdom. I therefore pray that this last minute preparation will qualify each one here for a lifetime encounter with God. Amen. Somebody believe that. Let me hear your loudest amen. Amen. Let me hear your loudest amen. Amen. It's very important at this juncture for us to understand that sin has a spiritual root and can only be rooted out spiritually. There is no technical solution to the subject of sin. From Genesis chapter 3, we saw Satan showed up in person. His name is the man of sin. To get man down into sin. So it's a spiritual conflict. You can't, there is no scientific, no technical, no technological solution to it. Sin is a spiritual disease and will require a spiritual solution. Sin is a spiritual disease and we only answer to a spiritual solution. Jesus said, watch and pray. Peter said, you don't know me. I don't need to pray any prayer. Anybody that shows up here, I will remove his head. I mean, I'm trained. And not even a man, a small girl. Ah, Peter, you are one of them. I said, never. When you are not, you don't give a spiritual attention to the subject of sin, any small demon can floor you. How is this a sin? Now, if you look at most of the issues that defy us, they are by demonic operations. For instance, the filthiness of Joshua the high priest was by the unclean spirit behind the sin. Satan standing to resist him and forced a filthy garment on his body. And God had to step in. Take off that filthy garment from him and give him a change of raiment. Somebody must receive a change of raiment here today. That looks like you. Let me hear your loudest amen. Now from Zechariah chapter 3 and verse 1 to 4, we saw Satan behind the scene working filthiness in the life of Joshua. The trauma of Peter was by machination of the devil. He said, Satan desires to have you. He wants to dislodge you. But I pray for you that thy faith faileth not. So it was all a satanic thing behind the scene. The rebellion of Judas was by satanic operation. Then Satan entered into Judas. Luke 22 verse 3. Satan entered into Judas. He lost his mind. When he recovered himself, it was too late. He was possessed of Satan, not of demons. He said, what? I saw the master. Too late. Threw the money down. Wow. He said, see to it yourself. He became a son of perdition by the operation of satanic corruption. Now, watch. These are all pointers to the fact that sin has a spiritual root and can only be rooted out spiritually. In 1 Kings 22 and verse 22, who will go? The Lord said unto him, wherewith? Let's look at verse 21. And there came forth a spirit and stood before the Lord and said, I will persuade him. Now, if you look at that spirit. Now, and the Lord said unto him, wherewith are you going to persuade him? He said, I will be a lying spirit in the mouth of all his prophets. And they will deceive him to go to war. Come and say, lying spirit. There are people who lie on things that don't even require them. They don't need to be part of it, but they will still lie. Lying spirit. So, sin has a spiritual root and can only be spiritually rooted out. Can only be spiritually rooted out. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12, the Bible says, but now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the thing that freely given to us of God. Now, something is identified here, the spirit of the world. The spirit of the world. What does he walk? 1 John 2:15 to 17. He said, love not the world and that thing that is in the world. If any man loves the world, the love of the Father is in him. What is the love of the world? He calls it the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. So there are demon spirits that work this in people's lives. The lust of the flesh. In the Corinthian church, people were having the wife of their fathers. Amen. People now live with animals. The lust of the flesh. The lust of the eyes, which is where thieves and robbers are made. Covetousness that destroys. Then the pride of life. Too big to be asked to do anything small. Thereby becoming too small to be asked to do anything big. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty heart before the fall. The spirit of the world is behind those operations. In the name of the Lord Jesus, and by the anointing of today, which is our Pre Shiloh anointing service ordained to get us fit, make us fit for his visitation, every such foul spirit shall be out of anyone's life. Sin has a spiritual rule and can only be rooted out spiritually. For if we live after the flesh, we will die. Romans 8:13. But if we through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, we shall live. So it has to be through the Spirit. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9 to 11, he said, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners shall inherit the kingdom of God. But such were some of you. But ye were washed, ye are washed, but ye are sanctified, and ye are justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. Sanctified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. So we can't be sanctified without the help of the Spirit, the Master Sanctifier. In Malachi chapter 3, he said, the Lord whom ye seek shall come suddenly into his temple, even the messenger of the covenant whom ye delight in, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. And when the Holy Ghost came, he came suddenly. But who may abide in the day of his coming? And who shall, he said, for he shall purify. Look at verse 3 of it. He said, he shall sit as a refiner and purifier of silver. And he shall purify the sons of Eli and purge them, the sons of Levi, and purge them thoroughly, that they may offer unto the Lord offerings in righteousness. So it takes his refiner's fire to sanctify us. That's a prophetic word concerning the Holy Ghost. And we saw him came down suddenly into his temple. And he came and sat down as a refiner and purifier of silver. Thoroughly purifying the sons of Levi, the priests of the Lord, that he may offer unto the Lord offerings in righteousness. Then shall the offerings of Levi be pleasant unto the Lord. Then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant to the Lord, as in the days of old, as in the former years. Now, what that means is, without the Holy Spirit, sanctification is impossible. Sanctification is what? It will convict the world of sin. It will convict the world of righteousness. It will convict the world of judgment. That's his mission. Of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. He's the one who judges those defiling demons from tormenting our lives. So without him, sanctification is impossible. But in the name of Jesus, as the Spirit of the Lord comes out from this oil today, it will bring an end to all your spiritual ordeals. One of us testified that every time she got a suitor, she fights them. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The devil wants to keep her solitary. And then Jesus came in and liberated her. And now she's gorgeously married. Whatever demonic activity is stopping your access to inheritance in Christ, as you are anointed today, they are destroyed off your life forever. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. To live the overcomer's life, therefore, we must continue to crave for the endowment of the Spirit of holiness. It takes the spirit of the fear of the Lord to live in godly fear. Isaiah chapter 11, verse 1 and 2, we saw the listing of the seven spirits of the Lord that was upon Christ in prophecy. And we saw among them is listed, and the spirit of the fear of the Lord. The spirit, verse 3, and the spirit of the fear of the Lord, verse 3, and shall make him of quick understanding the fear of the Lord. He can respond very smartly to every satanic incursion and deal with it. Therefore, by this anointing today, receive afresh upon your life the spirit of the fear of the Lord. Now, that was interpreted in Romans 1:4 as the spirit of holiness. And Christ was declared to be the Son of God with power according to the spirit of holiness by the resurrection from the dead. So the spirit of the fear of the Lord is simply the spirit of holiness. Therefore, by this anointing this morning, receive afresh upon your life a fresh endowment of the spirit of holiness. If Joseph had fallen victim of Potiphar's wife, he would have died as the chief chief of Potiphar, when he has a destiny of being prime minister of Egypt. Don't cut short on your destiny. It's precious. Your destiny is glorious. If there were a replay of what you should be compared with where you are, you'll be more serious. I believe it's time for a change of level. Vessels of gold, of silver, of wood, and of earth.
You make your choice. Earth means dust. Dust means the devil can feast on you anytime. Wood can be burned with fire, or you can't burn off silver. You can't burn off gold. Silver rejoices in fire because it takes off the things that do not belong from it. Gold celebrates in the furnace. So no matter the heat in life, you find gold just shining brighter, shining brighter. You are long overdue for a change of level. And a change of level you will have in this place. Therefore, let's respond and get ourselves prepared, because the best is around the corner and it must come in the name of Jesus Christ. To counter the spirit of the world, we need the endowment of the spirit of love. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. So we need a baptism of the spirit of love to counter the spirit of the world, so we can live the overcomer's life. With this in place, will be set for the next level. But please don't let Shiloh 2015 pass with you at the same level. Spend time today and tomorrow. Prepare yourself against Tuesday, that every moment at Shiloh will be a moment of divine encounter for you. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. Say with me, God is still appearing to people today. At Shiloh 2015, I must see God. I must see God. I must see God. Zacchaeus climbed the sycamore tree because of his short stature, because he must see Jesus. Jesus came down and said, come down. Today salvation has entered your house. The paralytic man said, I must see Jesus. Tore the roof open, threw him down from the place, and went back home made whole. When it becomes a must, God is committed to manifest himself. Say with me, I must see Jesus at Shiloh 2015. I must see Jesus at Shiloh 2015. Many have never experienced a divine appearance before, but this time you won't miss it. I said, this time you won't miss it. This time you will not miss it. This time you shall not miss it. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I've had God corner me at quite a number of occasions directly. I mean, unmistakably. You must meet God this time. You must meet him. You are long overdue to experience God. One of my sons was testifying that he got attacked. He was a copper and was organizing secretary and got attacked while they were busy ministering and setting people free, anointing shrines and breaking them down. And someday just got up, and then something like smoked fish was hooking his throat. To cut long story short, all the organs of the body came down. Kidney, liver, everything. Took him to the hospital, can't help him. Carried him to his state. The mother thought they brought him a corpse. There was no life to show. But one day Jesus showed up and took him up into the sky. Amen? Amen. Taught him what he has never had. Then Jesus, like, said goodbye, took off to the higher heavens. found himself on the bed. All the organs came back. Jesus is still appearing to people today. God recovers. No, not recovered. God instantly delivered. Come on, say instantly delivered. And got back on his duty as a copper. Instantly delivered. God, I must not miss you this time. I must not miss you this time. It's still appearing to people today. You are the next to encounter his appearance. He said, and the Lord appeared again unto Samuel at Shiloh. He revealed himself to Samuel by the word of the Lord. He revealed himself to Samuel by the word of the Lord. One day the Lord walked on the carpet. Because of his weight, there was sand on the carpet. Whoop, whoop. And reached his hand, touched my back, and something like hot water went down my spine. Got to church Sunday morning. Eruption, 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 eruption. You must not miss God at Shiloh 2015. From the Shiloh prayer hour, 5:30 to 6:30 in the morning, to the morning divine visitation session, to the specialized session that we'll be having, and the encounter night, the evening session, every session will be bringing you a visitation for your change of position. You believe that? Let me hear your loudest amen. What is in sanctification for me? One, sanctification guarantees your access. Access to your inheritance. Access. Free access to your inheritance. I commend you to God and the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give you your own inheritance among them which are sanctified. It takes sanctification to access your inheritance. It takes sanctification for me to access my inheritance. It guarantees your free access to your inheritance. Number two, sanctification guarantees answers to your prayers. Isaiah 59 verses 1 and 2, Psalm 66 verse 18 and 19. Number three, sanctification enhances access to fresh unction. You love righteousness, you hate wickedness. You are freshly anointed on a daily basis. Psalm 45 and verse 7. Freshly anointed. And with fresh unction, you live more than a conqueror, because your eyes will be seeing your desire upon your wicked. You are not fighting them. The fresh oil is fighting them. The fresh oil is bringing them down. And then you begin to flourish like a palm tree. All these are some of the blessings that are embedded in sanctification. And I know you want it. If you desire this, then it's important for us to subscribe to the need for sanctification. And finally, number four, from Isaiah 32 and verse 17, the work of righteousness shall be peace, and the effect of righteousness shall be quietness and assurance or confidence forever. And my people shall dwell in a peaceable habitation, in sure dwellings, in quiet resting places. Those are all amazing things that attend to us in sanctification. Peace, quietness, assurance forever. Peace, quietness, assurance forever. Receive this today in the name of Jesus Christ. Samuel was anointed, David was anointed in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon him from that day forward. And his mission is to destroy the yokes of our lives. So as this oil comes on your head, every yoke of sin is declared destroyed. And every effect of sin is rooted out. Therefore, sicknesses and diseases shall be healed instantly. Oppression of the devil shall be terminated instantly. And you're walking out of this service this morning, fully set, for encounter at Visitation Shiloh 2015. In the name of Jesus. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Very quickly, you are here in this service and you are not born again yet. Please understand that new birth is a prerequisite to be partakers of the Holy Ghost. Until one is born again, he cannot be a partaker of the Holy Ghost. So wherever you are this morning, you want to give your life to Jesus and be a partaker of the blessing of this morning through the ministry of the anointing oil as we administer that, please stand to your feet and I'll be praying with you. God bless you. Everyone that wants to give his or her life to Christ, please stand. You want to be born again this morning, please stand. God bless you. God bless you. Please stand. Everyone that wants to give his or her life to Christ this morning, please stand. You want your sins forgiven. You want your name written in the book of life. Please stand. This is your day. Please stand. Take advantage of this hour right now for a change of story. Remain standing, please. I'll be praying for you right there where you are. Somebody else wants to get up. Please do that quickly. Do that quickly. Do that quickly. God bless you. Amen. Can I ask that all of us who are there move to the nearest aisle to where you are? Some church officials are there to help you fill out your cards in good time. Please just move to the nearest aisle to where you are. Standing there. You'll be prayed for right on that spot. In the name of Jesus. There are also people here that need to rededicate their life to Christ. Maybe you are once saved. At the point I would say disconnect. But you want to reconnect back to God this morning. You want to rededicate your life back to Jesus this morning. Please stand to your feet also. God bless you. Stand to your feet. You want to rededicate your life to Christ. Please stand. You want to rededicate your life to Jesus, please stand. God bless you. God bless you. You want to rededicate your life to Christ, please stand. Wherever you are in this sanctuary, please stand. You want to rededicate your life to Jesus, please stand. You want to have a fresh new beginning with Christ, please stand. God bless you. Until the prodigal son returned, he was not restored. It takes a return to qualify for a restoration. Wherever you are, stand to your feet this morning. You are set for a new beginning, please stand. God bless you. If you are standing, please move to the nearest aisle to where you are, and then I'll be praying for you right on that spot at the same time with the others. Ushers, would you please help and make available to everyone this pack this morning? We have a pack of 6 items. The first is Shiloh 2015 Information Bulletin that gives you a foretaste so you can get acquainted with what things are required of you and what place to occupy in the course of this event. Also, we put this copy inside on the Grand Shiloh Testimony Encounters so that you can know what to expect and then get set for it. We also have here Understanding the Wonders of Shiloh Sacrifice that will help you to prepare yourself to meet with God on the altar of sacrifice. We also have here processing our Shiloh material sacrifice so you know why we are doing what we are doing and then align with it. Praise God. And then, of course, we have Shiloh 2015 Viewing Center listings for Lagos that will help you communicate with your new converts and invitees that may not be able to come in to Canaan Land Grand for Shiloh. We listed all the 52 centers here that will help you. Amen. And finally, we have the prophetic focus for the month of December. How many know that spiritual vacation is a risk? How many understand that? Spiritual vacation is a risk. So we are moving from Shiloh to get into the focus for the month, preparing ourselves for a launch into realms or from glory to glory in 2016. Can I hear your amen? Only the sanctified are ordained to be glorified. That is the prophetic word for the month of December. Please acquaint yourself with these materials and be set for the best of time this week at Shiloh 2015 in Jesus' name. There are materials that
you may also name, getting set for Shiloh. We have a few of them. So those who didn't have their copy can get their copies right now. And then Shiloh prayer intercession guidelines. You can be part of the last minute preparations for Shiloh in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. For all of us who are standing to receive Christ or to dedicate our life to Christ, please bow your heads for prayers right now where you are and lift up your right hand before the Lord. Please, those who are dividing these materials, no noise, just make sure we allow some quiet. All of us whose hands are lifted up, pray this prayer of faith after me from the depth of your heart. Say with me, Lord Jesus, I surrender my life to you today. Forgive me all my sins. Wash me with your blood. I believe you died for me. On the third day you rose again, that I might be justified. Right now, I proclaim you as my Lord and my Savior. And I believe that my sins are forgiven. I'm justified by your blood. I am now a child of God. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Thank you, Jesus, for restoring me. And thank you, Jesus, for making me a child of God. Amen. Keep your hands up as I pray. Father, I pray over these precious souls. Your grace has brought them in. Let the same grace preserve them. In Jesus' precious name, every hold of sin on your life is declared broken. And as you partake of this mystery today, I decree an end to every hold of the devil on your life. He has gotten you started, you will finish strong. None of you will miss heaven at the end of your journey. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Shall we all rise, please? Let the stewards come over and let us go to the video centers where we are partaking of this right now. First Samuel chapter 16 and verse 13. And he was anointed in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon him from that day forward. Somebody here, the Spirit of holiness is coming upon you from this day forward. Somebody here, the Spirit of the fear of the Lord is coming upon you from this day forward. Somebody here, your service in the kingdom shall never be in vain again after this anointing. Somebody here, your hanging inheritance as you are delivered from the hold of sin is released instantly. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. I'd like you to receive this with faith. The fire from this altar is reaching out to you via the medium of this oil. And as the Lord liveth, whatever you desire to come to an end in your life, every deadly habit you don't want to see again in your life, you see them no more again forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, this oil is sanctified and declared the Spirit of the Lord in a mystery. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' name, this is released to open up destinies today and destroy the hold of sin. In Jesus' precious name. Please get seated. No one is permitted to stand for now, so we can go with speed. And with expectation burning in your heart, begin to declare, calling by name, and taking it by force, whatever you desire of the Lord right now, in Jesus' name. Amen. One second to your forehead. We have only 8 minutes to be done with this, in the name of Jesus. After you have received that, begin to make declarations on the release of your desire. I am free at last from the plague of sin, free at last from the plague of unclean spirit, free at last and free forever from every form of defilement, free at last and free forever. Begin to make those declarations in faith, taking it by force, calling them by name and taking it by force. I am free from covetousness. I am free from the pride of life. I am free from the lust of the eyes. I am free from the lust of the flesh. I am free from the spirit of anger. I am free from the spirit of malice. I am free from the spirit of gossip. I'm free. Everything that defies is destroyed in my life by this anointing today. Come and do that by faith. Call them by name and take those things by force. Take your right by force. Take your right by force. At the same time, take your healings. Take your deliverances. It's your right. Take your healings. Take your deliverances. It's your right. Hallelujah.
My life with reason, my life changed. It touched my life with reason, my life changed. It touched my life with reason, and my life become a brand new one. Jehovah touched my life with reason, my life changed. It touched my life with reason,
my life changed,
my life changed. It changed for better.
My life changed.
It changed. It changed. It changed. It touched my life with his hands. My life become a brand new one. Jehovah touched my life.
My life with his hands. My life changed.
It touched my life with his hands. My life changed. Lord Jesus touched my life with his hand. My love changed. He touched my life with his hand. My life become a brand new one. Jehovah touched my life with his hand. My love changed. He touched my life.
He touched my life with his hand.
He touched my life. Changed. It changed. It changed.
He touched my life with his hand.
My love changed.
My life.
He touched my life.
He touched my life with his
hand. I'm a life become
a brand new one.
Jehovah
touched my life with his
hand. My life
changed.
He touched my life. He touched my life.
He touched my life with his hand.
My life changed. I'm nobody safe. God is changing my status.
He touched my life with his hand.
Every pain is gone. Every shame is rolled away.
He
touched my life.
He touched my life with his hand.
My life changed. I've become a brand new person.
He touched my life with his hand.
My life changed. He touched my life.
He touched my life with his hand.
I've become a brand new one.
But
Jehovah
touched.
He touched my life with his hand. My life changed. He touched my life with his hand. My life changed. He touched my life with his hand. And Malabricome, brother, what? He touched my life with his head, my life changed. He touched my life. From glory to glory, from glory to glory. Touch my body, touch my soul, touch my spirit, I make me touch my body, touch me, Lord,
touch my soul,
touch me, Lord,
touch my spirit,
I make me whole. Jesus, touch my body.
We all rise. If you have been ministered to, please rise so we know how many people remain. If you are here to be ministered to, please remain seated and then they'll be there with you in a moment. We're about closing right now. Praise God. All those who have been ministered to, please rise to your feet. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Lift up your two hands and begin to give God thanks for the touch of His life, His touch on your life this morning. We sing two times, my body is your sanctuary.
My body is your sanctuary. My body is your sanctuary. Purify me like gold, so that my people to save my body. Is a sanctuary. My body,
my body
is a sanctuary.
My body
is a sanctuary.
Purify
me from the sin. So that I'm my people. To say, to say,
is a sanctuary.
My body, my body, my body.
He's a sanctuary.
My body. It is a sanctuary. You're purifying me. Like what? So that my people.
To serve my body. He's a sanctuary.
Oh, my body, my body.
Blessed be your name in the name of Jesus Christ. May I offer this fatherly advice to all members of the Faith Tabernacle. the various centers are to provide opportunity for those who may not have the opportunity of a time out from their work. A number of people just got their miracle jobs. And because they must be part of this prophetic event, we make those provisions. But for every winner in his or her own business, everyone called jobless, everyone challenged in one way or another, Shiloh is a prophetic platform for realizing your inheritance in Christ. So, you are advised to be on ground for absolute concentration so you can make the most of this season. The old English adage says, opportunity once lost may never be regained. So, over to you. You don't have to have anywhere to sleep for 5 days. I've been in the forest for many days before, seeking God, not asking for butter and bread. And I found some things, and it's showing today. You must find things at Shiloh and return home with them that be showing every day in your life. Please give it a serious attention. Representations or delegates from 24 nations have already arrived. And you're living behind the fence. You are looking for where to watch the video. That's how serious you are about your life. I don't see why anybody in the world should be in any place called Vision Center in Sango. Doing what? Doing what there? You don't need a vehicle to travel from Sango to here. Don't need one. Only a serious approach guarantees a glorious result. Amen. Please take advantage of that in Jesus' name. Amen. The flag off is 7 p.m. on Tuesday. Amen. And that is marking the dawning of a new day in your own life. Amen. The encounters additional for you will be one you'll be talking about in the middle of your life. But it is sure to open new chapters to your life in the name of Jesus Christ. But much more importantly, get yourself properly prepared, properly set, spiritually set, determinedly set for a change of level. There's one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, another glory of the stars, and one star different from another in glory. You are long overdue for a change of level. And from glory to glory shall be your experience from henceforth. Lift up those two hands. The week is declared your week of testimonies. Testimonies of divine encounters. Testimonies of opening of new chapters. In the name of Jesus Christ. Together, let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship, everybody. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall be in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Peace. Heaven on earth and wonders without end. Help give that out to your neighbor right here, on your left, on your right. That's my new name and your new name. Don't forget there is covenant hour of prayer tomorrow morning. Be sure you are there in the name of Jesus Christ. If you have